Hello students, welcome to my YouTube channel, My Remote E-Class. I hope you are all fine and doing great. Today I shall take class on planned transportation. This is the first part of the video, and in the second part we will discuss about the transportation which takes place in our human body. When we talk about transportation, then fluid comes in our mind. Now, what are these fluids? It may be blood or lymph in case of us, whereas water in case of plants. And when we talk about blood, then various functions come in our mind. For example, transportation of nutrients. When we eat something, then it gets digested and absorbed by our body and carried to the cells, and they become part of our cells, and then again we inhale or we breathe in oxygen, and that oxygen is carried by blood again to the cells, and that oxygen burns up the cellular food to produce energy, water and carbon dioxide. We all know that we have a constant temperature throughout our body, and why does it happen? It happens due to transportation of blood or movement of blood from one point to another point of throughout our body. The hormones, which play a very vital role, they just carry it from the sources to the target organs by the blood only, and the waste materials are also carried by the blood. So there are various functions which are the part of the transportation of our bodies. Transportation also plays a very key role or very vital role in case of plants. For example, plants draw water and dissolved minerals from the soil, and those substances reach the leaves where the photosynthesis takes place and glucose is produced, and again that glucose gets transported to various parts of the plant body. That is also due to this transportation. So we can define transportation like this, that transportation is a biological process where movement of water and necessary nutrients to all parts of the plant body takes place. Now in plants, it is only water and minerals that need to be transported to other parts. Another thing that it needs to be transported to other parts of the plant is the food prepared in the leaves. So there are two aspects in plant transportation. One is the transportation of water and dissolved minerals, and another point is the translocation or transportation of food produced in the leaves to the various parts of the plant body. Now there are two conducting tissues in plants, xylem and phloem. Now let's go through the transport of water and minerals. Now plants need water for making food by a process called photosynthesis. They also need minerals to make proteins. Thus, a plant absorbs water and minerals from soil through roots and transport it to other parts like stem, leaves, flowers, etc. Two kinds of elements of xylem tissue. One is called xylem vessels or trachea, and another one is called tracheid, that play a very key role in transporting water and minerals from roots to the tips of a plant. Now here in this picture you can see the differences between tracheids and trachea, and tracheids are actually longer and thinner with tapering ends. Here you can see that these ends are tapering, whereas in case of vessels or in case of trachea, they are wider and cylindrical, joined at perforation plates. Now let's see the differences between tracheids and trachea or the vessels. Tracheids are actually elongated, narrow tube-like cells with tapering ends, whereas the vessels are wider, cylindrical shaped tubes. And tracheids are present in all vascular plants, whereas the vessels or trachea are present only in case of angiosperms. And the tracheids have a narrow lumen, whereas the vessels or trachea have wider lumen. The cell wall of tracheids are thick, whereas the cell walls of trachea or vessels are less thicker when we compare to tracheids. And the cells are elongated, thin cells comprised of tapering ends in case of tracheids, and in case of vessels or trachea, they are elongated, cylindrical, wider cells. End plates are not present in case of tracheids, whereas in case of vessels, they have perforated end plates. Now here you can see how the ascent of sap, that means the movement of water and mineral salts from the soil to the leaves of the plant, how does it take place here? Whenever transpiration happens, then what happens? There is a vacuum created immediately, and as a result, to fill up that vacuum, the water moves up from the root here to the tip of the leaves. Now, how does it happen? Capillary water present in between the gravels of soil move inside the root hair. This root hair is single celled and has a large cell vacuole, and then it reaches the epidermis, and then it travels the cortex region, which is made up of parenchyma cells, which are oval or round in shape. Here the cell to cell osmosis takes place, and as a result water moves up and they reach the endodermis, and it is followed by the pericycle, and thereby it reaches the tracheid and trachea of xylem of root, and from there they get connected with the xylem of stem, and finally they reach the leaf. This is how the water and mineral salts get transported in case of plants. Now let's see how the transport of food and other substances take place in case of plants. The food which is prepared by the process of photosynthesis in leaves of a plant has to be transported to other parts like stem, roots, branches, etc., and it is done by another tissue known as phloem. The transport of food from leaves to other parts of the plant is called translocation. These are the components of a phloem, and here you can see this is a sieve tube element, and companion cell is present just at the side of sieve tube, and there is a sieve plate which is present at the end sides, which is present at end to end, and it is perforated. Now phloem is a long tube made up of many cells joined end to end. Here you can see one end, here you can see one end, then this is another end, then this is another end. Here they are actually made up of many cells and joined end to end. They are called sieve tubes. So these are the sieve tubes, and the end walls of the cells of phloem have sieve plates. So these are the sieve plates. The companion cell which is present just beside the sieve tube has a nucleus, and there are also other cellular organelles. Now the food made in the mesophyll of a leaf enter the sieve tubes, and sieve tubes are interconnected, as I said, and once the food reaches phloem, it is transported to all other parts of the body. Now let's see how the mechanism of transport of food takes place in a plant. Now the food made in leaves is loaded into the sieve tubes of phloem tissue by using the energy derived from ATP. As a result, the osmotic pressure in the tissue increases and causing the water to move into it. This process is helpful in moving the food materials according to the needs of the plant. I hope you have understood the plant transportation. If you have any query, then do comment in the comment section box. I shall definitely reply. And if you like my video, then do like, comment, share, and subscribe. Thank you.